Hello dear students, today is the second class of graphs of functions, and today is the continuation of the previous class. Today we'll discuss about the graphical transformation mainly and several important graphs of different functions, especially on box functions, how to draw the box function graphs. So first we'll have the transformation fx transforms to fx plus minus a. This is called vertical shift. That is the if it is fx plus a is a positive number, so the graph shifted upwards. Look at that, the graph shifted upwards by a units. So this is the actual graph fx. If it is fx minus a, then the graph shifted downwards by a units. A is a positive number. So let us have some examples on that. Suppose the exponential graph, this is the exponential graph, you know that this is the exponential graph, and if it is how to draw exponential of plus 1, that is e to the power x plus 1, so it will be shifted upward with 1 unit. This is, and e to the power x minus 1, it will go downward by 1 unit, shifted downward by 1 unit. Also we can say about mod x plus 2, so this is your mod x graph as we know, and mod x plus 2, it will be shifted upward by 2 units, and mod x minus 2, it will be shifted downward by 2 units. So this is how you can transform the graph if it is fx plus minus a. A is a positive number. Second is fx transforms to f of x plus minus a. This is called horizontal shift. Fx plus minus a. So this is the actual curve fx, and this is fx minus a, x minus a, so it will shift the graph through a units towards right, that is along the x-axis, along the x-axis. And if it is fx plus a, it will shift towards left along x-axis by a units. A is a positive number. Suppose you have mod x again, and you want to draw mod x minus 2. So mod x minus 2 is simply, it will shift along the x-axis by 2 units, and mod x plus 2, it will shift along x-axis towards left along x-axis. So this is the horizontal shift. Similarly, we can draw a sine of x plus pi by 4, sine of x minus pi by 4. So look at that, this line is sine. This is your actual sine curve. This is your actual sine curve. Now if it is x minus pi by 4, it will shift towards right. It will shift toward right by pi by 4 unit. So this is your x of, this is your x of pi by x minus pi by 4, and this red line is your x plus pi by 4. So this is your x plus pi by 4 shifted left along x-axis by pi by 4. So this is how you can draw several graphs by using this horizontal shift. Now third is fx transforms to, suppose a fx, a is a positive number and a is greater than 1. So fx, if fx transforms to a fx, then that is called stretch of the graph fx by a times along y-axis. So if it is multiplied with a, then the graph will be stretched along y-axis by a times. And if it is fx is equal to 1 by a is greater than 1 into fx, then it will shrink the graph a times along y-axis. So it will stretch or shrink along y-axis. Let us have an example. Suppose y equal to, I want to draw y equal to cos x, y equal to 2 cos x, and y equal to half cos x. So this is your cos x. This is your cos x, original diagram of cos x, as you know. This is your cos x. Now, 2 cos x. 2 cos x will be stretched the graph along y-axis. This is your dotted lines, is the straight, this is your dotted lines are the 2 cos x. So, 2 cos x means 2 cos x stretch the graph along y-axis by 2 units. And half cos x means shrink the graph. Look at that graph, it's shrink, it's blunted, along y-axis. So this is the difference. This is your half cosec and this is your 2 cosec. So that is how the implication is that a into fx and 1 by a fx. This is the difference. Next, fx transforms to f of ax, a greater than 1. So if it is f of a times, in this case, shrink the graph of fx a times along x-axis. Now the difference is in x-axis. In the previous case, we have that shrink and stretch along the y-axis. Now shrink and stretch along the x-axis. So this is called horizontal, this actually horizontal stretch. So a times along x-axis and x by a means stretch the graph of fx a times along x-axis, x by a greater than 1. So have an example of that. Y equal to sine x and y equal to sine 2x. So it will shrink the, look at that sine x. This is your original sine x. No change. This is the sine x. Now if you see what is sine 2x. Sine 2x, it will shrink along, it will shrink along x-axis. Look at that. It will shrink along x-axis. This is sine 2x. Now what about sine x by 2? It will stretch along x-axis. So what about sine x by 2? It will stretch along x-axis. Look at the stretch. Look at the stretch. So sine x by 2. So that means sine x by 2 give you the stretch and 2x, 2 sine x gives you the, sine 2x gives you the shrink. To draw the graph of, next we'll draw the graph of y equal to f of minus x. When fx is given. So take the, actually the rule is that take the image of the curve y equal to fx in the y-axis as a plane mirror. So we will take the image of y equal to fx along y-axis as a plane mirror. So let us draw y equal to e to the power minus x. This is your e to the power x. This is your e to the power x. Now e to the power, you take the y-axis as the plane mirror. So e to the power minus x is this, it looks like an image, just as an image. So this is your e to the power minus x. Similarly, we have log x and we want to draw log of minus x. So this is our, this is your log x, this is your log x, and log of minus x is the reflection, a reflection on the y-axis as a plane mirror. This is how we can draw f of minus x. Now we want to draw f of minus fx. Minus fx. When y equal to fx is given. In this case, we should take x-axis as a plane mirror. Image of fx, x-axis as a plane mirror. So we want to draw e to the minus e to the power x when y equal to e to the power x is given. So this is your y equal to e to the power x, and this is your, so x-axis as the plane mirror, and x we take, this is as minus e to the power x. This is the reflection of y equal to e to the power x when x axis as the plane mirror. So in the previous case y axis as the plane mirror, in this case we take x axis as a plane mirror. Also we can draw minus log x. Yes, this is the log x, this is your log x, and this is your minus of log x, again taking x axis as the plane mirror. Now we want to draw y equal to mod fx. Y equal to mod fx means, suppose you have a, this is your fx. So there are several part in the negative part, negative fx less than equal to 0 direction. That is when y is negative. So these are the negative parts. These are the negative parts, negative branches. So you just take a reflection on the x-axis and just flip on the upward direction. This is also flip on the upward direction, but the nature of the curve remains same. This is the part and this is the part, and this was the original part. These dotted lines are the original part, but you don't take this one, just take the reflection on the x-axis and take it on the, and delete these negative portions. So this is how you have to draw mod fx. So let us draw mod log x. This is your log x. You take the negative part, dotted part, delete the dotted part, and take the reflection as a reflection on the x-axis, and nature of the curve remains the same. So how to draw mod sine x? Mod sine x also, you take this negative part, delete this negative part, and just flip on the as a reflection on the x-axis and delete this negative part. This is how to draw the mod sine x. Now how to draw mod of y equal to fx? Mod of y equal to fx, just there is a go through the rule first. Fx is non-negative and will be reflected about the x-axis only in those regions. So regions where fx less than 0 will be neglected. So the graph of y, mod y equal to fx, would exist only in the regions where fx is non-negative. So these portions are non-negative portion. In these portions the graph will exist, and delete where fx is less than 0 will be neglected. So in this portion there is a negative portion, we'll neglect this portion but take a reflection on x-axis, again this portion. So graph only in positive portions are exist, other portions are neglected. In this way you can draw the graph of mod y equal to sine x. So let us have an example of that. Few example, mod fx is equal to tan x. Look at that, tan x has a negative branch, so we don't take this negative branch, neglected, but you take the positive part exist and take the reflection on the x-axis. You take the positive part exist and take a reflection of this. In this case also positive part exist and take the reflection of this, neglecting the negative part. This is how to draw the mod y equal to fx. Again we have mod y equal to x minus 1 into x minus 2. This is a parabola. Actual parabola is this. This is your actual parabola. So mod y, that means the positive part exists. Look at that, positive part exists and the negative part is neglected, and take a reflection of that positive part on x-axis. So this is how to draw this type of graph. These are very, very important. So how to draw mod y is equal to mod e to the power minus x. So this is your e to the power minus x, and this is your, again take, this is your positive part, take a reflection of this. So there is no negative part, so that is why this is your mod e to the power minus x. And how to draw f of mod x? Suppose log of mod x. So this is how, this is your log of mod x. So reflection on the y-axis, this is your branch according to the reflection, taking y as a plane mirror. Mod of log of mod x. So log mod x, you know the reflection on the y-axis, and mod log x is the positive part on the upper part, that is you don't take the negative part. So in this case this is your mod log x, and this is due to the log mod x. So this is how you draw the log of mod of log mod x. There are several graphs on that. Next we'll discuss about box function, box fx, that is greatest integer functions. Here in order to draw y equal to box fx, we have to mark integer on y-axis first is that we have to mark integer on y-axis, then we draw horizontal lines through integers till they intersect the graph, then draw vertical dotted lines from these intersection points, and finally draw horizontal lines parallel to x-axis from any intersection point to the nearest vertical dotted line with blank dot at right end in case fx increases. So let us illustrate this. Yeah, this is the graph of y equal to x cube, and mark the integer on the vertical axis 1, 2, 3. Here also, mark the integer on the vertical axis, y-axis, that is, draw horizontal lines till it intersect the curve, draw horizontal lines. Now Draw vertical line from the intersection points. Draw vertical lines from the intersection points. Wherever you have intersection point, draw vertical lines. Draw vertical lines. In this case also, draw vertical lines. So on. So this is how. Draw vertical line. Now, from the intersection point to the nearest vertical dotted vertical line, you draw the graph with a blank dot on the right end because the function is increasing. Blank dot with the function is increasing from the intersection point to the nearest vertical dot. From the intersection point to the nearest vertical line. From the intersection point again to the nearest vertical point. This. So the green lines are the box functions in this case. That is, this is your box of x cube. This is your box of x cube. This is how to draw the box functions. These are very complicated, but you look at the rules and follow the rule and you can draw the diagram. So these are gives you. Now this is your one point, point one, and this is the, what is this point and this point. So let us check the calculation for this actual diagram and the calculation. This is your actual diagram in this case, and this is how the calculation. When the x is 0 to 1, then x cube is 0 to 1 also. In this case, box is 0. So look at that, the box branch is 0 in this case. X is, box is 0, but when x is 1 is 1 less than x less than 2, then 1 less than x cube less than 8. So in this case, we can split the this interval into 1 to 2, 2 to 3, so on. So 1 to 2 gives you 1 less than x less than 2 to the power 1/3. In this case, box x cube is 1. Look at that. You got the point 2 to the power 1/3. And in this range, box is 1. Got it? Next, we'll have 3 to the power 1/3, obviously. 2 to the power 1/3 to 3 to the power 1/3. And in this case, box will be 2. So look at that. The box is given by 2. This is your 2. This is your 2. Actually, the diagram is not complete here. And this point is 3 to the power 1/3. So in this way, we can draw the points. And we can draw the points and the graph also. So this is the explanation of how to draw box x cube. Now, let us have another example, box of x square minus 1. So this is the actually the parabola. This is the vertex. In this case also, from the vertical line, we mark the points integers and draw horizontal lines until they intersect the curve. From the intersection points, we draw vertical lines. And these are the, from the intersection point to the nearest vertical line, this is the actual box function. These are the actual graphs of box of x square minus 1. Let us find out the points in this case also. When it is 0 to 1, then x square is 0 to 1, then minus 1 less than x square minus 1 less than 0. So in this case, box is minus 1. Look at that, box is minus 1. In this side also, because if it is minus 1 to 0, again 0 to x square will be 0 to 1. So in 1 to 2, the box x square will be given by 1 to 4. So we can split the interval into, so x square minus 1 will be 0 to 3. So in this case also, we can split the interval into 0 to 1, 1 to 2, and 2 to 3. So in this case, box is, in this case, x square is given by, x square is given by 1 to 2. So x is given by 1 to root 2. So look at that point on the graph. Yes, this is your root 2. Similarly, we'll get root 3. So on. So these are the points, and this is how to calculate the box function and as well as the graph, how to draw the graph. So this is the graph of sine x, box sine x. Similarly, we can explain, and similarly, we can draw the graph of sine x. So this is your box of sine x. This is the branch. discontinuous at x equal to pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, minus 3 by pi by 2, so on. This is the box of cos x. This is your cos diagram actual, but this is your cos x. But this is your box function. The black lines are the box. This is your box functions. Box of cos x. Similarly, we can draw box tan x. All, so these are all important examples of box functions. So students, you can see the video and you can draw with the help of this video. Next, we have to draw box of x, f of box of x. So in this case, we'll take the integers on the x-axis and draw the vertical lines. So draw vertical lines till they intersect the graph of yx. And from this intersection point, draw horizontal lines parallel to x-axis and meet the nearest right vertical line. So as usual, so this is the graph. You take the integers on the x-axis, draw vertical lines first. Draw vertical lines in this case. In the previous case, we draw horizontal lines till it intersects the curve. From the intersection point, draw horizontal line parallel to x-axis to the nearest vertical line. This is the box function. Box f of box x. F of box x. So let us have an example. Yeah, this is your e to the power box x. This is your e to the power box x. So this is your exponential graph. First, we'll take the vertical. The first we take the integral points on the x-axis. These are the integral point on the x-axis. Draw vertical lines then till it intersect the curve. Till it intersect the curve. So these are the vertical lines through the integral points on x-axis. So these are the intersection points. Now from these intersection points on the graph, draw the horizontal line parallel to x-axis to the nearest vertical point with blank dot on the right because it is increasing. So these are the discontinuous point. So blank dot on the right end. So this gives you the box of e to the power box x, e to the power box x. So this is how to draw the e to the power box x. Now sine box x similarly, so this is the sine curve. The red lines are the sine box x because these are the integer points on the x-axis 1, 2, 3. So draw vertical lines first, draw vertical lines along parallel to y-axis, draw vertical lines. Intersect the curve. From the intersection point, draw horizontal lines with blank dot on the right. So these are the horizontal lines with blank dot on the right. This is how you can draw sine of box x. Similarly, with the help of this, we can draw sine, cos of box x, tan of box x, so on. So I hope this box functions, how to draw the box functions, are will be useful to you. Now, how to draw function f of fractional part of x. This is one example for you. 2 to the power x and 2 to the power box x. So that gives you 2 to the power x minus box x. So x minus box x is nothing but your 2 to the power fractional part of x. So this is the graph of 2 to the power x exponential functions, is general exponential functions, and this is the part where it is the part in the 0 to 1. This is the part where it is lies in 0 to 1. X is 0 to 1. So this part gives you the fractional part. So your nature will be remain same for the other part. So this is how to draw 2 to the power fractional part of x. Look at that. This nature of this curve is same here, and you take that branch only and the other branch will be like this. So this is how, and there is a blank dot on the right end. And as you know, fractional part lies between 0 to 1. So in this case also, and look at the nature of the graphs, this is same. So this is how to draw 2 to the power fractional part of x. So written the graph of fx for values of x lies between interval 0 to 1. And now it can be repeated for rest of the points. This is how to draw the fractional part of x. Next, we have sine of fractional part of x. So sine of fractional part of x, look at that. This is your part into 0 to 1, this is your part in 0 to 1. So we can retain that part, look at that nature, and also this part also. So this is how the same explanation. So this is how to draw the fractional part of sine x. Now lastly, I will talk about maximum and minimum of some functions. So suppose there are two functions fx and gx, they are how to draw their maximum part and minimum part. Suppose we have to draw maximum part of 2x and x square. So let us have, this is your y equal to 2x as straight line, and this is your y equal to x square is a parabola. So their maximum part will be given by this portion. This is your maximum part and also this. So lower part will be neglected. This is how the dotted part is your lower part. So lower part will be neglected in maximum part, maximum of a functions, of functions, and minimum of a function will neglect the upper part. So in this case, if you want to draw the minimum part, minimum of x comma x square, so this is the minimum part. So this maximum part will be neglected. So this is how to draw the maximum and minimum part of functions. So we have talked about so many types of functions and their critical type of box functions. So I hope this video will be helpful, very helpful, to solve so many problems in calculus, especially dealing with continuity, differentiability, integration, in especially in the problems of JEE and IIT. Thank you all.